A six-year mission involving experts from China and around the world is about to commence.
Vertical is a different story. Horizontal,
they will make thousands of tests to discover the secrets of a special technology. But this is not a new technology, it is an old one. One whose skills seem all but lost.
先是贴中间的，然后把这张压过来。
听说 TK 说要保一百年，有可能吗？
啊，一百年肯定没问题。啊，
湿度温
湿度温度可以控制
了，不像过去是我这门开着。
但是这立面，顶面它也顶了，它有一个。
Early in 2005, experts meet in Beijing's The Forbidden City. Their mission is to restore a unique piece of Chinese history. 这是 the Duan Qianzai, literally the studio of exhaustion from diligent service. The Emperor Qianlong of the Qing Dynasty had it built for his retirement from worldly affairs at the end of the 18th century. In early 2002, the Palace Museum, in partnership with the World Monuments Fund, took on the ambitious restoration project. WMF's representative, John Stubbs, was stunned by his first visit.
My eyes adjusted to the darkness, and I saw the most fantastic architectural features I've ever seen in my life. I could see that this was something of the greatest historic and artistic significance. It was just speechless.
Qianlong was a noted connoisseur and collector, perhaps the most famous in all of China's history. When first built, the studio would have been an exquisite masterpiece of art and architecture.
Tour led me to the most magnificent room of all, which happened to have these all important trompe l'oeil paintings on the walls. I sensed in a second that I was touching highly important Chinese history firsthand.
The murals exhibit the influence of Western art in their use of perspective. In fact, in the first half of his reign, Qianlong had been an enthusiastic patron of Giuseppe Castiglione. Castiglione was a Jesuit lay brother and painter who arrived in China in 1715. He's three successive Chinese emperors. After a year's preparation, the project begins with conservation work on the huge landscape murals. Each step presents a serious challenge. How do they detach the murals from the walls? How do they clean the canvases without damaging them? And return them to their original brilliance. The international team of restoration experts are all assembled. Cao Jinglo was a very experienced restorer of paintings. He's worked at the Palace Museum for over 20 years. In that time, he has restored countless ancient paintings and books.
我们这次就原汁原味了，你原来是什么样的材料，有也好，没有也好，我们都要去寻找、去调查，找到最原始的东西，而且用中国最传统的、最原始的方法去来恢复。
T.K. McClintock is a specialist from New York. He brings some of the latest ideas and methods to the project.
I'd worked on many big projects, but I'd not worked in China before. So it was a terrific opportunity. It's one of the great schools of conservation.
The project has just started, but there is already disagreement over how to detach the huge paintings from the walls. They first try using spatulas, but the pigment on the painting is too fragile. It is autumn in Beijing, and the air is very dry. Removing the fragile murals from the walls presents a considerable headache. TK suggests dampening the edges first and then trying to insert the blades, but this still doesn't crack the problem.
We began going in underneath the murals with spatulas and slipping a spatula in between the layers and shaving off the layer of paper adhered to the back of the mural. That was not always as safe as we would have liked, so we had to take the whole sandwich of materials down.
Another obstacle facing the team of experts is in deciding how to move the mural segments out of the confined, narrow space. TK suggests that the 12 sections of mural be taken outside and the painted silk be removed there. The Chinese team point out, however, that even when the 12 murals are separated, each piece will be 3 meters across. There is no way the pieces will fit through the doors.
Mr. Tao is very experienced. Even though we have separated the murals into some sections, we can't steam them out because each section is still too wide. So we decided to take the 12 sections down and roll them up.
Good job. Good job.
Everyone thinks they have solved the last major obstacle, so no one is expecting that removing the wall murals will present yet another setback. Using traditional Chinese building techniques, the murals were formed by attaching the painted silk to strong backing layers of Korean mulberry paper. The paper is then stuck to the plaster wall. They're going to have to be separated with extreme care. By July 2004, the 200-year-old landscape murals have finally been separated from the walls and the ceilings. The team is awed by their exquisite beauty. Cleaning away the dust wasn't as straightforward as hoped.
一个浮尘, 还有就是 时间长了已经渗到那个纤维的那个夹缝之间的一些尘土，是吧？但是基本上也是浮尘，它渗的比较深了。They
tried several cleaning tools on the canvas, but these would all leave scratches, no matter what was used. Then Sam found inspiration in his family kitchen.
Cao
Jinglo tests his culinary skill and comes up with a mix that he thinks will do it. The pliable dough is rolled across the surface of the murals.
它一搓，就是那用那面的那种，它的粘结度很低的粘结度全粘上了。 所以非常白的面团一搓都完了，老搓都变灰的了，黑的，就说明这尘土全掉了，而且那画面非常之干净，而且颜色非常之鲜艳，而且也没有掉色。
With the faces cleaned, the next stage is to repair the backing layers that support the silk. The backing paper is called life paper, which is exactly what its correct restoration means for the murals.
Because, 咱们中国这个裱画是传统，有很长的历史了。这种历史一直延续下来，就是这种传统办法。所以一个画面后面都有命纸，所以命纸就是保护它的生命的纸嘛，就是最里边这张纸。
这个纸呢，就是当时我们从墙上接下来原来的墙里高丽纸。
这就是200多年前的高丽纸。
对，200多年前的高丽纸。
Mulberry paper was introduced to China from Korea over 800 years ago.It was a luxury product, much prized by the upper classes. In Chen Lung's time, the emperor used it as a protective wrapping for his treasured books and artifacts. And 200 years since, the production of mulberry paper has all but disappeared. Mulberry paper was handmade, and techniques to make it are rarely practiced in the industrial age. It is not clear how the restorers will be able to replace the mural's backing.Jing County in Anhui is one of the few places this type of handmade paper is still produced. Paper made from tree bark, like mulberry, is known for its resilience. They have been making paper on this site for 1500 years. Mr. Cao hopes he can find a paper that will substitute for the rotted backing of the murals.Cao returns to Beijing with paper samples for specialist analysis. First, modern paper is compared against the handmade paper. Through the microscope, the textures of the two are completely different. The handmade paper has long fibers that knot together.However, the handmade paper fails the resilience test. They suspect the problem lies with the type of bark used. It turns out it's the wrong tree. What they really need is mulberry. The mulberry bark has longer fibers, which in turn makes a much stronger paper.The question is, where to find a craftsman who still has the skill to make such paper? This is a piece of mulberry bark paper. The long fibers are clear to see. It is very resilient.
我分析原来的乾隆高丽纸，它的耐折度达到6000多次，原来的就那非常的拉力啊，间接强度非常高了，说明就是原来古代做纸啊，那质量非常好。
The restorers must go and search for a mill that is willing and able to try to replicate the 18th century original.For the whole of that march, Sam and his team scour the paper mills of Fujian, Zhejiang, and Anhui. Although they find craftsmen who still practice the ancient techniques, none of the paper in current production can be found to match up to the qualities of the Qianlong era paper.It's the spring of 2005. 2 years have passed since the restoration project started. No paper can be found to replace the vital mulberry backing paper of the murals. In the meantime, the murals are sent to the conservation room for sterilizing. This process will enhance the life of the silk by protecting it from moths and mold.
来，慢点。哎，好，来。
那它对文物有没有负面作用？
它对文物几乎没有什么负面作用，因为它有一个很好的解析性、渗透性和挥发性。就即使我们用塑料把它包裹起来，它也可以达到这个杀虫剂的功能。 它还原原的气体能够穿透到包装里边，哎，等你消毒结束之后，充分的解析出来，就不会在这个被消毒物品上有什么残留，因此呢，它就不会有什么，这个文物不会产生什么，包括文物的质地啊、颜色呀、这个感官呀，都没什么。11分钟了吧？我们现在这里面温度升高1度，才要升高6度，要等。
Cao Jing Lo keeps searching for someone who can make a mulberry paper to match Chen Long's. While waiting for this to be resolved, the murals will go into temporary storage. Cao is running out of options as he sets off on yet another trip, this time to Tianshan. The history of papermaking here can be traced back several hundred years, but times have changed. People have started new industries, all except for one man. Yu Yifu owns a paper mill by a stream deep in a valley bottom. Cao's hopes are raised.
A small river beside it has a deep hole. Water flows out after the hole is filled, then flows back. The water is alive, flowing continuously. Then I put the small river's water in a glass bottle. We took it back and analyzed it. I said, "This water." 是偏碱的，松，这个或者是中性的，就可以用。如果要酸性的，我说你就不要用这个，因为使了这个水以后，它对这个纸的这个质量有非常大的关系。After
the raw materials are pulped, they are put in white linen sacks and washed in the tank. Acidic water can damage the bark fibers and affect the paper's durability and strength. Tests show that the water seems ideal. Now they have to find the right starting materials. The requirements for the production of this special mulberry paper are very exacting. Ordinary mulberry fiber is too short with too little elasticity. Yu Yifu believes he knows where to find the right trees.
这就是我们给故宫修复铜镜花做那种全能高丽纸的那个桑树，野生桑树，野生的桑树，它跟家养的那个养存的那个桑树是两回事，它的叶子和内在的那个皮的拉力都不一样，那野生的它的拉力特别强。你看这树皮的，你看一看就能看出。跟那纸的颜色一样的，你看，纤维多长，这个更白，你看多好，大的纤维里面还有长了毛，毛就是那个小的那个纤维。你看，这就是我们做全能高丽有用的那个，里面把老壳扒掉的那个树，有用的树皮，这个白的。
By the spring of 2006, the restoration team feel they have made a big breakthrough. After a full year of searching, they have found someone who can make the classic long fiber mulberry paper they need for the murals. As Cao Jing Lo pays close attention to Yu's papermaking process, he discovers that one step isn't actually done by hand.
它那全是金属的嘛，全都是那个用那个柴油机来带。这发现这种打法呢，就容易把那个纤维打得特别短，所以我们帮助他来改造一些新设备。
The adjustment is a success, and the mixer now produces longer fibers. But there is still a durability problem. Lab test reports indicate the percentage of wood pulp. Is only 20%. Perhaps it's because after pulping, the bark and stem fibers are not adequately separated. Some suggest boiling the pulp for longer. It's not easy to reproduce the skills of the old papermakers in producing these long fiber papers to the highest standard. They face a slower and more demanding process.
那就煮皮嘛，煮皮之后就是漂皮，漂皮也是反复的烤，反复的煮，那就不是一次两次了，那就靠对方要求的白豆和那个纸的拉力和需求。
The tree bark is boiled repeatedly in Yu's mill, over 30 times in total. However, this finally solved the problem of strength and endurance, thanks to a little scientific help. Their Maori paper is now a perfect match for the 18th century original. It is a tremendous achievement for a village paper mill.
Today, our paper can be used at the Guangzhou Guangjin Dai. For me, I feel very happy.
Yu's mulberry paper will protect the murals in the Forbidden City and help bring the Emperor's private retreat back to its former glory. But more challenges lie ahead for the restoration team. Into the project, and having restored the murals, the team have to work out how to repair 200-year-old silk embroideries. Can they find anyone who still remembers how?